Aquarium is really different than any of my previous books. It's the first one that's not a tragedy. It's a family coming back together in the end. It's set in a city in Seattle, not out in the wilderness. It has a more simple writing style to it, and it has nothing to do with my family. It's the first book that my family's not afraid of for me. So the main character is Caitlin. She's 12 years old. She goes to the public aquarium every day after school. She loves the fish, just as I loved fish when I was a kid. And she meets an old man in the aquarium. And this old man is actually trying to get back into the family. He's her grandfather. And the test in the book is whether or not Caitlin's mother will be able to forgive her father, who left before and left Caitlin's mother in a terrible situation, whether she'll be able to forgive him so that Caitlin can have a grandfather. So the book is about forgiveness and a family coming back together, and has nothing to do with my family except that my mom and I didn't get along for years and we had to learn how to forgive each other. And so I think that that's what I was really writing about. How is it you can forgive someone you loved and needed and were very close to, but you had a very long, terrible split from, a terrible divide. How do you heal that? How do you come back together? So there's still a bit of my own story in that it's about that theme of forgiveness, but there's no characters from my family, no situations or events or places from my family. I didn't grow up in Seattle. I knew Seattle though, because I grew up in Ketchikan, Alaska, and we'd always go through Seattle. And I did have all these fish, all these aquariums scattered throughout the house. When I was 12 years old, I had 7 fish tanks all throughout the house, and all weekend I just cleaned the fish tanks, which may have affected my social life. I don't know. My biggest influence for this book was actually the Seattle Public Aquarium. I'd gone there years before, and the little descriptions by each fish tank were like poetry. I mean, they really suggested human behavior. They were talking about the fish, but they said something about us. And I loved that so much. And that's been my method in all my books, to describe the natural landscape and have that indicate the inside life of the characters in some way. And so describing fish throughout the book was such a pleasure. And each time I was doing that, I was describing Caitlin's vision or her grandfather's vision. You can see what they think of themselves and other people through what they think of the fish.